thing, I'd like to introduce Korean traditional paper. We use traditional paper all the time, but this is traditional paper called Hanji. So we got all different Korean traditional paper, but this one is very thick. For example, this one I did a rainbow moon. I using this very thick paper because it can hold that very strong blue and the color. And then this paper is very medium thick. And then another one is paper is very, very thin and really delicate anyway. So it depends on your pain. You can choose all different kind of paper as well. And next one is, we're using Korean traditional paint for the ink stick and ink stone. So put some water, just grinding the ink, you make the ink and paint. But today we don't have enough time, so I bring some ink, so we already made it. And then next thing is the brush. So brush, I already prepared like this. So the really long stick with the long here as well. So we're using this one usually making a big line and big paint. And next one I show you, this one is long here as well, long here as well. But different thing is this brush and this brush, we usually using this long here, using for the line. And this one brush is very short and little bit upward here, using for the coloring. So it got, we're using for the different type of paint. And then, but it got all different size as well. Depends on your paint, you can choose as well. But look, this one got really tiny and really small as well. But this one usually doing very delicate stuff and fine line and things like that. And then next one, brush. And next one, I show you the color. We usually colors. This one is easy to use it, already made up like this, the two. But I always prefer using this one for the coloring because this one is natural stone. Natural stone is very pure and beautiful, clear color. You can see natural stone. You can't just paint it because it doesn't have the glue in it. So what you can do using with mix with this glue. But this one doesn't look like glue. But you boil it and it will melt. And then you mix with this one natural stone. You grind it, natural stone, and mix with this glue. And then you can paint it like this. But this paint, you will you have to put lots of layer to make the, this kind of color as well. This time I put some gold. Can you see the shinier one? Mm-hmm. I didn't bring the gold powder, but yeah, we can use the gold powder as well.
When you are boiling the brush or the thing, do you add a bit of water as well?
Yeah, you have to put a water, certain amount of water or a certain amount of this. This is called agyo. Agyo, boil it, but you can't just really boil it top. Too hot temperature, you have to boil a certain temperature so it doesn't ruin the glue or thing. So this one is made up of the animal bones and like, you know, fish bones, things like that. To, yeah, they're traditionally using it. So then, yeah, but yeah, this is, I will show you the colors later, but this one, I always prefer this because it's got really pretty colors coming. And then next thing, yeah, that's all I show you that for our very important Korean materials for the Korean paint. So next step, I'll show you the basic, really basic of the Korean paint. So I prepare the, I prepare already the paper like this. So what we can do, the really basic step of the paint, usually you have to make the three different shape one line. So first thing, you put some water on some ink. So I'm not gonna run here for a long time, so I'm gonna use this one today.
먹물도 팔어.
So with ink stick, something like this. Yeah, I always do before I do my painting, running for a long time. Gotta put lots of water. The first thing you have to make the basic of the shade, very light color. Mix it all. Very light mauve color here. You can see. And then take a little bit off. And a little bit off the other one. Check different shades in one brush. Like this, you can see that are dark from the light. So what you can do, once you start from learning Korean paint, you have to practice this one over and over many times. That's what I did it when I started. So you can practice not only one line, you can do all different lines as well. Like this curve and up and down. Like this. That give you a control of the brush and the control of the shape in the brush as well. So this is the basic of the Korean painting. That is just, I'm going to show you that my painting, how I did it. My painting this time, I'm going to show you, I use that very thin hanji. Because the hanji also depends on your paint, what you can do. If you can choose different type of paper. So I use very thin one. And this one, I got the, when you paint it, you have to find out which paper you use, which side you can use. So you touch it, you will feel the very smooth. Yeah, you touch it, you will feel it very smooth than the other side. The other side a little bit rough. Draw little rocks in the middle, so that I need to do the dark color first. So I put more dark ink. The rock is very rough, and the surface is very, the texture is rough. So I'm using very dry and rough line, and slowly get it lighter. Because it, when I finish the dark part, it slowly release the ink. Light colors come like this. And then if you put some more dark, some dark, this, make more dark, so you control as well. And then next step, I'm gonna draw, next one is, I'm gonna show you that sand. Thinking it's sand, it's dry, isn't it? So I have to show a little bit of dry and you need to take all the water out. The water out, take some brush a little bit up here, like this. Some down a little bit in, and then just one by one. And then you will see very... dry things coming. So you can keep control and check what shape you like it. Dry and dusting, you can see. Then, next one is the water. I'm gonna throw the water. And water, if you're thinking water, it's a little bit smooth and calm thing I wanna express. So, we put lots of water. This time, lots of water, and I don't need a strong color, so I just need a little bit of more. Check before you do. Going very smooth. This. And then next one, gonna the heel and the far away. The heel. It's not that strong, but it's light color. Every time it depends on your pain, you can change the brush as well. The right. One of the thing is this one, if you leave it water too much, it will spread everywhere. So I just quickly with this one, after drawing, just press down so water didn't go spread everywhere. So this water goes there, instead of spreading, it goes here. So push down. Roughly, the technique I show you, the raw sand, the dry part, like this, the sand, the water goes smooth, it's really up, and then the heel going that, like this. And then pretend this is finished. So what we can do is, we can't just, when you finish paint, we can't just put the frame like this, because this paper is very thin and very delicate. So you can't just protect with the frame. Oh, sorry, I forgot to color. Sorry. The next thing, the last thing I couldn't like show you that how to use this color. Tiny bit of the rock. So, usually you use warm water. I already put the warm water. The cold water, it didn't come out very color. So using warm water. And when you do this painting, this kind of painting, you have to use the glue to do it. But this painting, don't need to use the glue. So just using very light. Very lightly. Okay, yeah, now we So this one, yeah, like I said before, this is very delicate. We can't just put in the frame. So what we're doing usually, we're doing mountainous with another paper. Another paper, very thick paper. We're using special glue. Put this one under this paint, like this. We're using this brush. Put the glue all over and just put it. Make sure you all stick with these two paper together. So once put it properly under there, you can see it more clear color and then rotating the paper as well and preserve it. And then next one is when you finish this paper and then I create this on seal, or usually Korean painter, they creating their own seal. So this is my name in there. So using this to this and just putting a seal stamp whatever thinking it is. So putting like this, your own seal. And then when you finish this, this is my real painting.
The very thin, delicate paper.
Yeah.
But then you had to mount it on the heavier paper. Why didn't you do your painting on the heavier paper to begin with?
Ah, okay. Yeah, that's another thing. Because this thin paper, it spread the water really, really well. Once you remember, I said the water paint, show this water side. Once you put the brush coat, the spray really well, but this thick paper didn't really spread much like this thin one. So when I'm doing this paint, this kind of painting, I'm using thin one, so make sure the one I want to express it how I feel. And this one, I use a very thick one because it doesn't spread the water much, so I can use the coloring on the top of it in many, many layers. Yeah, that's what I choose.
After you apply glue on your finished work, when you're framing, you frame last.
Yes.
So you paint first, glue, and then frame.
Yes.
So did you do the same procedure as the back?
Yes, everything, every time when I finish paint, then I do mounting it, then I put on the frame.
So it's backwards.
It's a different direction.
Yes, kind of. And also, but because I got another different way as well, but this one is very, very thick paper. So what I did it, I don't need to do this mounting, but I put this paper first, and then I did it this one. Because this one is the really, really thickest one. This thicker than this. You can come and feel it, it's really, really thick. So you can hold that this glue for really, really well. That's why I use really thick one, because I put many, many layers in on the top. Yeah.
That kind of the papers that you can put on the more layer, this is thin.
Yeah.
You can put on the more layer, just the one thinner. Can you pull?
You can, but better choose thick one to holding the glue. You can. This one I use it not that thick, thick one, and so that's why I didn't put many layers. But this one I put a lot of layers. It depends on what kind of painting.
If you put on the more layer, this thin paper doesn't ruin the painting.
It's not gonna ruin, but you have to put this glue before you do this paint. one is protecting the paper.
That's the one stroke skip for. I don't like that, and then I can adding a little bit more dark color into the put on the rock.
Yeah.
And then, oh, this part is a little bit more dark.
Yeah, yeah. You can. Yeah, you can. Many layers you can put that in.
I like these works very much.
Oh,
thank you. Can you tell us a little bit about your ideas?
Okay. Alright, my rainbow moon is moon. It's just moon, just nature of the moon. But once we have traveling, that time my daughter was looking at the sky. Mommy, rainbow moon. And she said to me, and then I look at it. Oh, it's just moon. But she's thinking it's a rainbow moon. So when people thinking it's something they put in their idea, they put the feeling, they put the thought, it becomes something else. So this time I put it my feeling and my thinking in to my pain. So it's just, you know, something you can change the nature of the what it is. I thought. But some of my friends will ask why? The moon is so big. You're probably thinking, because I want to put the big space, empty moon space for you to think. You can look at it, you can put in your feeling as well. That's why all my moons are big. Even the audience that we were asking about, the audience, that audience also. We can't be happy all the time also when you see the moon. Like my daughter was thinking that time probably she was very happy to see the moon. So maybe she was thinking, oh, it's a rainbow. But when I saw that time, I was quite tired. So I didn't feel like a rainbow moon. But, you know, I can put my feeling as well too. I was very happy and was, you know, was a treat. It was very adventurous thing for our family. So I put all different names. But so maybe I was very complicated, tired. So I put another name on the audio of the pen. But that was I using for more traditional technique in that rolls and things like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why I'm coming here. Yeah, my painting is that.
That rock, then they have the little bit, the car, what is it, the red
car? The red car, this time. I tried to put my family thing in this time, my painting. It was my the inspiration coming to our family trees and family thing. I want to so, and also in part of my life and my family is very important, become really important. So I just put a little car, red car, all kinds of red. Yeah.
Oh, this is your family in the car.
Yeah, family in the car. So in my
this
life.
Is also this.
Yeah, but I want to pass that all these things in my life, so I just put it in the end of the car. Yeah,
and then now with the rainbow.
Yeah.